अस्सलाम वालेकुम जी। आज हम चैप्टर नंबर 4 विच इज़ बेसिकली कॉम्बिनेशनल लॉजिक, इसको रिव्यू करेंगे। चैप्टर नंबर 4 डील करता है कॉम्बिनेशनल लॉजिक को, और कॉम्बिनेशनल लॉजिक बेसिकली डील्स करती है कि हाउ वी डिज़ाइन द सिस्टम्स एंड इन द फॉर्म दैट इन कैन सॉल्व पर्टिकुलर कॉम्बिनेशंस। कॉम्बिनेशन लॉजिक जो है वो बाय इट्स नेम इट्स डीलिंग विद द कॉम्बिनेशंस, एंड कॉम्बिनेशन कैन बी एनीथिंग। यू कैन से टू वन्स आर टू, टू टूज आर फोर, दीज आर बेसिकली पर्टिकुलरली कॉम्बिनेशन। इस सिस्टम के अंदर कोई मेमोरी एग्जिस्ट नहीं कर रही होगी, सो आप जैसे ही कोई इनपुट देंगे उसके कॉरिस्पॉन्डिंग जो उसका रिजल्ट होगा दैट विल बी जनरेटेड एंड दैट रिजल्ट विल बी डिस्प्लेड अकॉर्डिंग टू योर डिज़ाइन सिस्टम। सो अ कॉम्बिनेशनल लॉजिक सर्किट हैज़ ए सेट ऑफ एम बुलियन इनपुट्स, एम बुलियन इनपुट्स and n boolean outputs, n switching functions each mapping the two n input combination to n bits such that the current output depends only on the current input values. इसको हम यहाँ पे अगर खड़े होके देखें तो we can understand that this system is basically relying on the current inputs and based on those current input it basically computes the corresponding results and then give you the answer. एक typical counter that counts from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and let's say if it's a BCD counter and it goes back to the 0. So in that particular case that has a specific sequence. After 5 it is assured that 6 will come. But in a combinational circuit if you are making a specific adder like an increment operation adder that has a fixed input of A and a fixed input of 1 that just increments. So whatever the input is at A, let if it's a 5, 5 plus 1 is going to be 6. And then if you randomly give it 10, it is going to give you 10 plus 1, 11. But it's not going to remember the previous state. That is one difference between a combinational circuit and a sequential circuit. That sequential circuit works on a sequence and the next sequence is computed based upon the previous input. In combinational circuit we are only concerned with the current input, and at that current input we generate the next output. So what's the design procedure? Design procedure is basically writing specification for the circuit if one is not already available. Drive a truth table or initial Boolean equation that defines the required relationship between the inputs and the outputs. If not in specification, apply hierarchical design if appropriate, and then apply the optimization, multi-level optimization, draw the logic block diagram, provide a netlist, and resulting circuits are in the form of AND or inverters. And then we apply the technology mapping, and then after technology mapping, the verification is done manually and using simulations as well. So design procedure of a combinational logic is basically referring to the problem solving techniques that initially we do not know anything about our problem. We just have a specification, a written specification from the client, from the manager, from the boss, from the teacher, and then after seeing that specification we convert it into a truth table where all possible input are written, and then all those outputs are also written, the relationships in defined, and then we define different techniques that we have read before like K-maps, Boolean algebra to simplify it into a system that we can use. And then we have these like equation in SOP forms and POS forms, and we then convert those SOP or POS accordingly to NAND mappings or NOR mappings. This is basically done after the optimization is done, and then the final circuit is simulated maybe in Proteus, maybe in some other software, just to see that when we give all possible inputs the outputs are according to the inputs. And then if it's done correctly, if it's showing the results as desired, we convert the system to a practical PCB and then use the corresponding ICs that we have simulated in our design. So this is the design procedure for a combinational logic system. And let's design a system. Let's design a BCD to XS3 code converter. BCD is binary coded decimal, and XS3 code is basically a special type of code that adds a plus 3 to the BCD digit. So transform BCD code for the decimal digit to XS3 code for the decimal digits. BC code words, as we know, binary coded decimal starts from 0 to 9, 4-bit pattern from 000 to 1001 respectively. So after these things, it is 9, it comes back to 0. It doesn't have a 10. So don't confuse it with the hex code, which is basically an equivalent 4-bit code that goes from 000 to 1111. So don't confuse it with the hex code. This BCD code terminates, and it is basically from 0 to 9. So XS3 code word for digit 0 through 9, basically a 4-bit pattern consisting of a binary 011 added to each BCD code word. And then implementation can be multi-level circuit, NAND gates, including inverters. And first we need to formalize the problem, and conversion of 4-bit code that can be mostly easily formulated by a truth table. And we have like inputs, BCD inputs, we define A, B, C, D, or any variable that we intend to define. And then the output variables are, let's say, W, X, Y, Z. And since we are not using the patterns from beyond 9, let's say 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 are not being utilized. So we can basically say that these patterns will be don't cares, so that we can simplify our design and hence have a optimized circuit. So you can see 0, 0, 0, 0, let's say this is 0, and this is like 1, 2, and it's been gone, and it's basically 9. So basically 0 plus 3 is going to be 0, 1, 1, and when 1 plus 3 is going to be, let's say 4, and this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 9 plus 3 is going to be 12. So we can maybe we can theoretically speaking, we can have an XS4 code maybe just to have a particular system by a particular client. We can have other type of systems as well, but for this problem we are using the XS3 code. So once we have done, we'll apply the optimization technique using the K-maps. Since we have W, X, Y, Z, four variables, so we will be solving four K-maps for each output function, because there are four inputs and there are four outputs. 1, 2, 3, 4, four outputs are there, and since there are four outputs, so we'll be requiring four K-maps, and these K-maps will be solved accordingly as per the discussion of the previous chapters. And after this thing will have a two level K-map that will correspond to W, X, Y, and Z. I hope you can now solve these K-maps and get the final equations as desired. So if we map this A, B, C, D on this W, for example, if you want to see one example of it, so we can write the corresponding 5, 7, 9, 11, 5, 7, 9, 8, 9. All these are basically coming from this aspect. W is coming from this aspect. So you can see तो W जो होगा हमारे पास वो इस हिसाब से हम इसको मैप कर सकते हैं ऑन द के मैप. और ये के मैप के ऊपर आपको नज़र आएगा कि यहाँ पे एक टर्म्स जो हमारी बन रही होंगी वो ए के एस्पेक्ट से बन रही हैं. ठीक है, सिंस वी आर इंक्लूडिंग द डोंट केयर्स, सो यहाँ पे हम इस ए को करेक्ट लिख सकते हैं. ठीक है, इसी तरीके से जो दूसरी आपकी जो टर्म्स बन रही हैं दैट आर बेसिकली बी एंड सी. सो बी इज़ फ्रॉम basically here, and C is also coming. So BC is a term that you may be writing from this, and this is basically BC, and the third term is basically B D. So this is the B and this is the D. So this third term is basically the B D. So equally you can solve all these other equations to get the optimized two level circuit in the form of a sum of a product, and then we can use multi-level optimization again to reduce the number of circuits that we have used in basically solving this equation. So यहाँ पे आप जब optimization करने जा रहे हैं तो यहाँ पे आपको जो चीज़ नज़र आएगी वो एक common factor W के अंदर नज़र आ रहा है. It's like we can be written as let's say A plus B common C plus D. And in second equation, if you take B bar common, it's going to be B bar C plus D. And then, so the common factor C plus D is again used, so we can write this as T, and then T1 is equal to C plus D. So we can write this W is equal to A plus B T1, and this same factor is basically used in X is equal to B bar T1 and B C D. And then we can again use this thing to minimize, again repeat these circuit again and again. So this is a type of an optimization by which we can reduce the number of gates from 23 to let's say 19 by using a common gate factor. So multiple level optimization can be done in this form, and we can reduce the circuits to further from 19 to 16. How? This is the discussion that we are going to continue. So to further reduce this thing, we can basically use this Boolean transformation, which says C bar D bar is equal to C plus D whole bar. Remember, we are taking this C plus D as a common factor, and the equal transformation say that this can be written as T1 bar. So we are going to reduce this same thing. Wherever C bar D bar is going to be used, we are going to substitute the value of T1 bar, hence reducing our number of gates from 19 to 16. So these type of optimization are only possible through looking at the equations very intuitively and knowing all the Boolean algebra and the rules that we have read in chapter number 2 and chapter number 3, so that we can reduce this circuit to as minimum number as possible. So after applying this thing, we can now move towards technology mapping. So first level mapping containing inverters and two input NAND and two input OR gates are being done. So you can see W is equal to A plus BT1. We are using A directly with a plus, let's say this is an OR sign, and then BT1. So B input is directly coming here, and then T1, basically it was C plus D, this was C plus D, C plus D is coming here, and this is, we are using this term as T1. So wherever this T1 is coming, we'll take the input from this node, and hence we can basically reduce the number of gates, and this is basically the technology mapping at the two input basically level. We can further reduce this thing by using the NAND mappings, because if you use the NAND mapping, the technology is focused to a particular IC, and the implementation becomes easier rather than using multiple types of gates, like say AND gates, OR gates, and NOT gates. We can focus our energies towards a single technology mapping, that is, we can use the NANDs or the NORs to execute the circuit. So hierarchical design जो है उसको अगर हम आगे लेके चलें, so इसके अंदर basically हमारे पास complexity of the function of mapping inputs and outputs are controlled, and we'll decompose the function into smaller pieces called blocks, decompose each block function into smaller blocks, repeating as necessary until all blocks are small enough. Any block not decomposed is called a primitive block. So primitive block basically हमारे पास वो block होगा जिससे further design आगे reduce नहीं हो सकेगा. So collection of all the blocks including the decomposed one is a hierarchy. So हम एक example लेते हैं, 9 input parity T एक बनाना चाह रहे हैं, और इसमें जो top level design होगा उसमें 9 inputs हैं और 1 output है. हायर लेवल के ऊपर अगर हम इसे देखें, और अगर हम इसे फर्दर डिकम्पोज करेंगे तो इसके साथ हम छोटे प्रिमिटिव ब्लॉक्स तक इस डिज़ाइन को लेके आएंगे ताकि हम कंपोनेंट्स को रीयूज़ कर सकें। सो यहाँ पे आप ये देख सकते हैं 9 इनपुट्स हैं और एक आउटपुट है। ये टॉप लेवल डिज़ाइन है, इनिशियली आप इसको ब्लॉक डायग्राम कह सकते हैं। जब आपको अपने सिस्टम्स का फर्दर आइडिया नहीं है कि सिस्टम के अंदर फर्दर जो डिकम्पोजिशन हैं वो किस तरीके से हो रही होंगी, सो आप जो है अपने डिज़ाइन को इस तरीके से चलाएंगे कि हायर लेवल के ऊपर सारी इनपुट्स और आउटपुट्स को मेंशन कर देंगे। आफ्टर हैविंग एन एनालिसिस कि इसके अंदर कौन से ऐसे ब्लॉक हैं जो रिपीट कर रहे हैं, ठीक है, वी कैन आइडेंटिफाई दोज ब्लॉक्स, और फिर हम उन ब्लॉक्स के थ्रू जो है अपना सिस्टम जो है वो बना रहे होंगे। इस केस में हम जो है वो 3 इनपुट ऑड फंक्शन सर्किट जो है उसको यूज़ कर रहे हैं, और हमने इस डिज़ाइन को 3 हिस्सों में फर्दर डिवाइड कर दिया है एट वन लेवल, और फिर इसकी जो इनपुट्स हैं वो एक जगह के ऊपर कलेक्ट हो रही हैं। तो फर्दर ये जो आपके पास हर जो इसमें से इंडिविजुअल ब्लॉक है उसके अंदर यही वाला जो सर्किट है वो यूज़ हो रहा होगा। सो दिस कैन बी कन्वर्टेड टू ए NAND मैपिंग एज वेल, सो दैट ऑल द टेक्नोलॉजी इज़ ऑन अ सिमिलर IC। सो हायरार्किकल डिज़ाइन इसी तरीके से आप देख सकते हैं कि टॉप लेवल से अगर आप देखें तो सिर्फ आपको ये नज़र आएगा, और अगर आप बॉटम लेवल पे देखें तो आपको लेट्स से NAND गेट्स जो हैं वो सारी जगह के ऊपर नज़र आ रहे हैं। सो ये कुछ मैपिंग्स हैं जो बुक से थी दैट आर यूज इन एंड NOR एंड NAND मैपिंग्स। सो एंड कैन बी रिटन एज NAND विद एन एंड नॉट, दैट इज बेसिकली x.y। इस तरीके से आप और जो है उसको यूजिंग NAND गेट्स इस तरीके से रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं। अगर NAND गेट्स की जो इनपुट्स हैं वो कॉम्प्लीमेंटेड हैं तो दैट गेट कैन बी रेफर्ड टू एज एन OR गेट। सो कुछ एग्जांपल जिसमें आप एक AND और गेट को कन्वर्ट कर रहे हैं टू इक्विवेलेंट NAND गेट। यहाँ पे आपने इसको यहाँ भी नॉट लगा दिया, यहाँ भी नॉट लगा दिया, तो इससे कोई टेक्निकली स्पीकिंग फ़र्क नहीं पड़ेगा डिज़ाइन के अंदर, बट इक्वली दिस सर्किट कैन नाउ बी रिप्रेजेंटेड विद द NAND गेट। तो ये सारी जो टेक्नोलॉजी है ये आपकी किस में चलेगी, NAND टेक्नोलॉजी में चलेगी। शुरू में ये इसमें एंड्स भी थे और इसमें और भी थे, और यू कन्वर्टेड टू ए सिंगल टेक्नोलॉजी दैट इज़ NAND टेक्नोलॉजी। सो reusable whenever possible वी ट्राई टू decompose a complex function into common reusable function blocks. These blocks are verified and well documented, place in libraries for future use as well. So हम इन components को जो बार बार use हो रहे होते हैं इनको एक library के अंदर रख सकते हैं, and then we can reuse them rather than writing the code from the scratch each time. So this is basically a top down design from an abstract high level specification to a more detailed design by decomposing and successive refinements. इसमें आपने देखा कि पहले एक हाई लेवल डिज़ाइन था आपके पास, सिर्फ एक ब्लॉक डायग्राम थी जिसमें 9 इनपुट्स थी और एक आउटपुट थी, सो हमने इसको टॉप डिज़ाइन कह दिया। सो बॉटम अप डिज़ाइन स्टार्ट्स विद अ डिटेल्ड प्रिमिटिव ब्लॉक्स एंड कम्बाइंस देम इनटू अ लार्जर एंड मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स फंक्शनल ब्लॉक्स। डिज़ाइन यूजली प्रोसीड्स टॉप डाउन to known building blocks ranging from complete CPU to primitive logic gates or electronic component. Much of the material in this chapter is devoted to learning about combinational block used in top down design. So यहाँ पर हमने exactly वही बात की है कि known primitive block, शुरू में हमें नहीं पता होगा कि हमारा system क्या है, हम उसकी inputs को और output को define करेंगे और फिर known primitive blocks तक उसको लेके जाएंगे bottom up approach तक। तो NAND मैपिंग्स आप इन एक्सरसाइज को कर सकते हैं कि आपके पास AND गेट है, उसके साथ आपने एक NOT गेट लगा दिया, साथ इधर भी NOT गेट लगा दिया, सो इक्वली यू कैन कन्वर्ट ए AND और NOT टू ए NAND मैपिंग। सेम इज़ द केस विद द NOR मैपिंग्स। सो वंस योर डिज़ाइन इज़ वेरीफाइड यू कैन शो
that the final circuit design implements the original specification, and this specification was related to the truth table that you basically made Boolean equations and the final STL code. If above results from formulation are not to the original specification, it is critical that the formulation process be flawless for the verification of the results. So हम truth table और Boolean equation और STL code को verify कर लेंगे. Verification जो है वो हमारे पास manually truth table के through हो सकती है, या हम इसको STL का code इसका बना सकते हैं, which can be verified by plugging in the test bench, जिसमें हम अपने design को software के अंदर ही inputs देंगे और फिर जो results निकल रहे होंगे as a result of that SDL code, हम उन results को analysis कर सकेंगे. और इस simulation procedure को जो है वो हम बड़े अच्छे तरीके से analyze कर सकते हैं software के अंदर ही, और अपने design के जो glitches हैं उनको find out कर सकते हैं. तो यहाँ पे एक BCDO-XS3 की जो schematic है वो बनाई है कि आपके पास inputs क्या थी A, B, C, D और output क्या थी W, X, Y, Z. और आपको याद है कि अगर input 0 दे रहा था तो output 3 आ रही थी, इस तरह 1 दे रहे थे input तो ये 4 आ रही थी, मतलब 0, 0, 0, 0 आप देंगे तो यहाँ पे let's say 0, 0, 1, 1 आपके पास जो है वो आ जाएगा. तो यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं, let's say आपने input जो है वो यहाँ पे आप combinational के अंदर यही चीज़ है कि आप कोई भी random input in the range, let's say A, B, C, D जो है उसके अंदर जो भी हमारी रेंज बन रही है, जो वैलिड इनपुट है बी सी डी की, वो 0 से लेके 9 तक है. तो 0 से लेके 9 तक आप इसके अंदर कोई भी जो नंबर है वो दे सकते हैं, और इसके रिज़ल्ट में आपको जो आउटपुट है वो आपके फंक्शन के हिसाब से मिल जाएगी. ठीक है, सो लेट्स से यहाँ पे मैंने अगर दिया 0 0 0 0, तो आउटपुट पर मुझे क्या मिला, 0 0 1 1. You can see this is basically 1. और as soon as you change the combination to, let's say यहाँ पे 0 है, ये भी 0 है, ये भी 0 है, and this is 1. So यहाँ पे आपके पास क्या हो गया, 0, this is 1, this is 0, this is 0. तो अगर आपने 1 दिया तो 1 + 3 is going to be 4. इस तरीके से अगली चेंज जो नोटेबल चेंज आ रही है, let's say 0 0, let's say 1 0, तो यहाँ पे क्या हो गया, 0 1 0 1, this was 2 + 3 = 5. So you can see के जैसे आप changes input के ऊपर दे रहे हैं irrespective of the combination, let's say आप 2 के बाद direct 5 भी दे सकते हैं, 4 दे सकते हैं, 6 दे सकते हैं, जो उसका corresponding होगा element वो output के ऊपर आपको show हो जाएगा. This is combination electronics, और ये उसी की एक example है जिसमें हमने एक specific function को जो है वो map किया. So the function considered are those are found to be very useful in design, corresponding to each of the function is combinational circuit implements called a functional block. So these are basically the system that we design, and one more technique is basically the rudimentary logic, in which function of single variable of x are mentioned and can be used on the input to functional blocks to implement other than the blocks intended function. So यहाँ पर हम जो हमारे पास जो भी हमारा है input है उसको उससे हम output को relate कर सकते हैं. ठीक है, so let's say अगर मेरी x input है, इसको मैं अगर समझने के लिए x 0 input है, और मेरे पास जो एक x की दूसरी input है वो 1 है, x के ऊपर एक function जो है, let's say let me do this like f2 f3 f4, ये चार फंक्शंस हैं. ठीक है, तो फॉर एवरी वैल्यू ऑफ x फॉर f1 द आउटपुट रिमेन्स 0, फॉर एवरी वैल्यू ऑफ x f2 अगर 0 होगी तो f2 0 होगा, 1 है तो 1 होगा, इस तरह यहाँ पे x 0 है तो आउटपुट इन्वर्टेड चल रही है, नज़र आ रही है हमें. सो वी कैन राइट दैट x इज़ बेसिकली इन्वर्टेड फॉर f3 and x is basically 0 for all values of f1, and x is basically similar for all values of f2, and for f4 this is basically all the time 1. So these functions can be represented and then can be simplified by using the values that come at the output function. ठीक है, इनको हम कर सकते हैं, अगर हमने वन रिप्रेजेंट करना है तो हम उस फंक्शन को पक्का पक्का वन के साथ टाइट कर देंगे. लेट्स से इस केस के अंदर एफ वन को यू कैन सिंपली टाइट इट टू द ग्राउंड रिप्रेजेंटिंग ज़ीरो. ठीक है, इफ़ इट्स एक्स तो यू कैन जस्ट राइट इनपुट को आउटपुट के साथ कनेक्ट कर सकते हैं. नो नीड टू मेक एनी कॉम्बिनेशनल लॉजिक इन साइड योर सर्किट, बिकॉज द सिंप्लीफिकेशन से जो इनपुट है वही आउटपुट है. And let's say for every value of input, the output is inverted. Just put an inverter between the input and the output. These type of techniques are very useful when you are simplifying your system. So, अगर आपको ऐसा कोई pattern नज़र आता है, that is basically following these things, we can use the following rudimentary logic functions to simplify our system. So, multi-bit rudimentary functions. We can use these things like notion of a bus. कि let's say अगर आपके पास इस तरह का एक सिस्टम है तो आप इस तरह मल्टीपल चैनल सिग्नल्स को रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं एक बस की फॉर्म में. ठीक है, और उसमें आप जो है वो उसका कॉरस्पॉन्डिंगली बता सकते हैं कि जी ये सिग्नल जो है उसकी क्या वैल्यू है, दूसरे सिग्नल की क्या वैल्यू है. यहाँ पे एक चीज़ देखने वाली ये भी है कि बस जो है अगर आ रही है तो उस पर आप ये बस की विड्थ लिख देंगे, ये 4 है. दिस कैन बी लेट्स से 8 बिट की बस हो सकती है. ठीक है, 16 बिट की बस हो सकती है, किसी भी बिट की. यानी बस इज़ अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सिग्नल जो बेसिकली एक कम्बाइन इफेक्ट जो है वो आपको बना के दे रहे हो. ठीक है, सो यहाँ पे हमारे पास जो है वो सिग्नल जो है वो इस तरीके से काम कर सकते हैं. सो यहाँ पे बेसिकली बताने का मकसद ये है कि कम्बाइंड सिग्नल जो है वो आ सकते हैं, और इट कैन बी पॉसिबल कि हम इनको अलग अलग रिप्रेजेंट कर दें. कि एफ़ बस के जो सिग्नल 2 और 1 है वो यहाँ पे आ रहे हैं, और एफ़ बस के लेट्स से सिग्नल 3 और 0-1 जो है वो हमें एक डिफरेंट जगह के ऊपर मिल रहे हैं. तो दिस इज़ पॉसिबल फॉर कॉम्प्लेक्स डिज़ाइन. यू कैन यूज़ दिस टोपोलॉजी टू शो द वैल्यूज़ ऑफ योर डिज़ाइन. देन वी हैव अनेबल फंक्शन. अनेबल इज़ बेसिकली अ फंक्शन दैट रिप्रजेंट्स a control in a gate. Let's say simple enable, अगर हम ये इसको कह रहे हैं कि ये enable का function है हमारा. ठीक है, so let's say let me write this thing as 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. This is basically a NAND gate का मैं एक table बनाना चाह रहा हूँ. एक input को मैं कह देता हूँ enable, let's say EN, और एक input को मैं कह देता हूँ X. पहले मैं इसको कह रहा था ए, इसको कह रहा था बी, जस्ट चेंजिंग द नेम. और लेट्स से यहाँ पे मैं 0 0 0 1 मैं फॉलो करता हूँ सेम एंड गेट के जो मेरे पास था. सो देखने का इसका एक तरीका आपका चेंज हो जाएगा, द परसेप्शन इज़ गोइंग टू बी चेंज. एंड यू कैन सी इफ़ आई से दिस इज़ अनेबल पिन. सो इफ़ अनेबल इज़ 0, वट एवर द इनपुट इज़, whether it's 0, it's 1, the output is going to be 0. And if enable is 1, so if input is 0, output is 0. If input is 1, output is 1. So it is basically following whatever the X is. So I can say this AND gate, if I put the enable 0, output is going to be 0. But if enable is 1, output is going to be X. So you have a notion of control here, and you can control the data. If enable is close, your data will not go at the output, and if enable is open, your data is going to be at the output. And you can use an OR gate with a similar philosophy, but with a inverter at the input, and this can be possible by putting an inverter at the enable. So this function is also possible. So enable function will be used in many multiple concepts, like if we want to make a higher level anything that has a attached enable with it, we can just put a AND gate and pass the output of that function through X, and then control the output through the enable pin. So the value on the output when it's disabled can be high Z for tri-state buffers. Tri-state buffer is a similar concept that we discussed earlier as well. So this is a simple buffer, and this is basically a tri-state buffer. Tri-state buffer, if enable is on, so whatever is input will go at the output. But if enable is off, whatever is at the input does not make an effect at the output. And if it's connect, it is basically simulating if it's not connected. So this is basically a tri-state buffer. Tri-state buffers are very important when we have bus-based designs. So a simple example can be like you cannot control, you cannot connect two AND gates directly. I cannot connect two AND gates like this because अगर इसकी जो है वो ज़ीरो इनपुट है आउटपुट है और इसकी आउटपुट वन है तो यहाँ पे क्या होगा, यहाँ स्मोक होगी, ये ख़राब हो जाएंगे, आपको एक रिलायबल आउटपुट यहाँ नहीं मिलेगी. ठीक है, सो इफ़ आई नीड टू कनेक्ट द आउटपुट्स ऑफ माई सिस्टम आई नीड टू हैव ए लाइक अ ट्राई स्टेट बफर हेयर एंड देन अनेबल पिन एंड द बस कंट्रोल विल मेक श्योर दैट एट एनी मोमेंट इन टाइम only one of this enable is on. If both enables are on simultaneously, it is again a flawed system. In digital system, this is not allowed. So the bus driver should make sure that at each instance of time only one output is allowed to be enabled, so that the output from here can travel to the shared common line. So we'll see some advanced concepts like decoding, encoding, mux, demux in this coming slide set. So decoding, basically a n bit binary code can be represented by up to m equal to 2 n elements, and if we have like m elements, we can encode these m elements to n bit binary code. So if we have like 256 alphanumeric numbers, they can be represented by 8 bit code. So decoding the conversion of n bit input code to an m bit output code, and the equation should follow this limits, and it cannot exceed these limits, so that each valid code word produces a unique output code. सो लेट से यहाँ पे हमारे पास जितने भी इनकोडिंग के वर्ड्स आ रहे हैं 0001 1011, सो लेट से अगर आपके पास ये पर्टिकुलर एलिमेंट्स आ रहे हैं तो यू कैन बेसिकली यूज़ देम टू इनकोड अकॉर्डिंगली. सो 8 एलिमेंट्स जो हमारे पास होंगे 2 की पावर 3, 2 की पावर 3 इज़ बेसिकली 8, इस 2 की पावर 4 इज़ 16. So this is basically what is a meaning of m equal to 2n, and this limit should be followed. So decoder example further, a BCD to 7 segment decoder. This is a special type of a decoder that basically allows us to give a BCD code, and that BCD code is going to be converted to equivalent pattern that will show the equivalent number. Let's say if you have 0000 here, the output LEDs are going to show the zero pattern. So all the LEDs corresponding to zero pattern are going to be on except for this middle one. So if you have going to have, let's say 0001, तो यहाँ पे हमारे पास फिर क्या आ जाएगा, 1 की जो एलईडी होगी वो सिर्फ शो करेगी, इस तरह 2 होगा तो 2 की एलईडी शो कर रही होगी. ठीक है, सो ये एक स्पेसिफिक टाइप का जो है वो डिकोडर है, जहाँ पे आप क्या कर रहे हैं, एक कोड दे रहे हैं, लेट्स से एक कोड जो है वो आपका रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है आपके बीसीडी डिजिट को, और उसके कॉरस्पॉन्डिंगली एक स्पेसिफिक पैटर्न है जो उसकी जो एलईडीज हैं उनको ऑन कर रहे हैं. ठीक है, so we can have a similar thing like example of these decoder are BCD to 7 segment decoder, binary to ASCII, and address recorder in memory is also there. So example is a 4 megabit DRAM. So at each individual of time, only one particular cell is going to be, let's say, active. So row address is going to be given and column address is going to be given, and that those addresses are particularly make a unique line on in this case, and this is going to point to this memory cell, and this cell can then transfer the information from here to the outer world. So these are example of decoders, and let's say a simple decoder, 2-4 line decoder, 2-4 line decoder, 2 to the power 2, 2-4 line decoder, and let's say if I give 0, 0, it's going to make this thing on, all the other are off. If I'm going to give 0, 1, the correspondingly different things are going to be on. So 2-4 line decoder, only one of the input is active. So if you are basically having a let's say LCD or CD-ROM, mouse, hard drive, only one thing is active at one moment in time. All the other things should be off. We cannot have multiple things on at same time. So what is required here, that 00 pe D0 on ho jaye. D0, let's say aap isko CD ROM keh rahe hain, isko keyboard keh rahe hain, isko aap mouse keh rahe hain, isko aap hard drive keh rahe hain, and this is the logical expression that is corresponding to, let's say D0 will only be on if A1 is 0 and let's say an A0 is 0. Corresponding iski equation logical expression would be something like this thing, and if we take these as min terms, we can basically convert this thing to a circuit that will be our decoder circuit. So let's say the main target is this thing. If apply 0, 0 here, this thing should be on. So if apply 0, 0 here, this is going to be, let's say, 0, this is going to be 1, this is going to be 1, and this is D0 bar is going to be 1. Let's say I apply 0, 1 here, so this is going to be, let's say, 0, it is going to be 1 here, and then the other thing is going to be 1 here as well. So this is going to be on. So depending upon what I apply here, let's say I apply 1 here and 1 here, and this 1 directly comes here, and this 1 directly comes here, this becomes 1. So D3 is 1. So this is basically a circuit for a decoder, 2-4 decoder, and it decodes the 2 bits into equaling 4 bits. And this is a direct decoder, so one of the output is going to be on for a given combination. This is not like a BCD27 decoder. So a large decoder can be realized by implementing each min term using a single AND gate. However, for large decoder, it is required that multiple input AND gates, which is not always feasible. Better use hierarchical approach to build large decoders from smaller decoder. And the approach is the output AND gates have only 2 inputs and implement the min terms, and the output AND gates are driven by 2 decoders with the numbers of input either equal or differ by 1. So if you want to, let's say, make bigger circuits, 3-8 line decoder will use, let's say, 8 AND gates, 2 input AND gates, and we can represent a 2-4 decoder and a 1-2 decoder to make this simple circuit, 3-8 decoder. So a simple inverter here is basically called a 1-2, let's say, decoder, and by combining this thing we have a 3-8 decoder. So if I apply 0, 0, 0 here, this is going to be on 1, and let's say 0 here, and this is going to make 0, 1, and only this thing is 1, and if this term is going to be 1. So correspondingly, whatever I apply here will represent the equivalent number. If I apply, let's say, 1, 1, 1 here, so this term is going to be 1. Now, this is going to make 2 of these, let's say, D3, 1, and at the same time, it's also going to make D7, 1. So you can see this pin is connected here, and this pin is going here as well. So now this pin is going to decide whether this is on or this is on. So this one will make a zero here, because one here, this was a zero here, and this zero is going to make this thing and all others zero. At the same time, this line is also attached here, and this is only 1, so the next is 1, the D7 is going to be 1. So this is basically a 3 to 8 line decoder. This was 1 to 2 decoder and 2 to 4 decoder, and we can make a bigger decoder, that is a 3 to 8 decoder. So further decoder expansions, we have made this thing 2 to 4 decoder and 1 to 2 decoder, and the number of AND gates will be equivalent to the number that we are making a decoder. Let's say 3 to 8 decoder will use 8 AND gates, and all these AND gates are basically used as an enable function, as discussed earlier in previous slides, and so they will control the output. So what's the rule for building a large decoder? The rule is simple. We'll have to make this equation, k to 2k decoder, one needs 2k output AND gates. Let's say we had a 3 to 8 decoder, so let's say 3 to 2 to the power 3 decoder, which means 3 to 8 decoder. So we needed 2 key power 3 AND gates, 8 AND gates were required. So if k can be divided by 2, use a k to 2k2 decoder, and if k cannot be divided by 2, use a k plus 1 divided by 2 decoder, and k minus 1 divided by 2 decoder. So in previous example, we use a 3 to 8 decoder where k cannot be divided by 2. So 3 to 8 decoder, k cannot be divided by 2. So we use this formula. So 3 plus 1 divided by 2 decoder, and 3 minus 1 divided by 2 decoder. So this was basically a 2 to 4 decoder, and the 3 minus 1, 1 to 2 decoder. So all we need to know is the first number, and on that number we can decide what the other is. 1, 2, 2, 4, and 3, 8 can be used. So if we have like bigger decoder, if k could have been divided by 2, then we would have used this equation. So how many input and output gates are required if we want to make a 4 to 16 decoder? With smaller decoder to use, and let's see the circuit. So 4 to 16 decoders, one rule is we will need 16 AND gates as an enable function. So first thing is simple, and we can make these terms like, this is just writing as 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. So A 3 bar, A 2 bar, A 1, A 0 bar. So this is similar as writing a truth table, but in the form of these variables. So 4 to 16 decoders, 4 can be divided by 2, So we will use k divided by 2. So k divided by 2 is basically 2 to 4 decoder. We'll use 2 to 4 decoders to make a 4 to 16 decoder. So these terms are matching. One input is going to get from here. So you can see if it is 0, 0 here, this is going to be on and this is going to be on as well. And next thing is going to be decided by this decoder, which one of these 16 is going to be 1. So if it's, let's say it's a, again a 0, 0. So if it's a 0, 0, the 1 comes from here and it basically moves here and this is going to be 1. Simple. And if it's not, then the its output is going to be 0. So we can make bigger circuits, 5 to 32 decoder. Definitely we are going to use the number of AND gates I described earlier. And 5 cannot be divided by 2, so k minus 1 and divide by 2 and k plus 1 divide by 2 formula is going to be used. You guys can take a moment and try to make this thing and then see the solution after some seconds. So yes, 32 AND gates are going to be there, and a 3 to 2 decoder, a 3 to 8 decoder and a 2 to 4 decoder will correspond to a 5 to 32 decoder. 7 to 128 decoder, definitely we are going to have 128 gates at the output. And the main thing is you understand the structure of the decoder. This is a normal decoder, not a special decoder like a BCD to 7 segment decoder. So normal decoders are easy to understand. You can make a block diagram, make the number of inputs and number of outputs, and we can correspondingly make these things. So if you want to make a decoder with a enable gate, like I said before, enable is just a function that basically controls the output of the system, whether your output is going to be there or not. So this was a normal truth table. We have added the enable input as a third input. So if enable is 0, all output is going to be 0. If enable is 1, the corresponding factors are going to be implemented as shown in the truth table. So 0, 0, D0 is going to be 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, D2, 1, 1, D3. So enable has only help us in controlling the output of the function. So if you want to practically make the enable circuit in the 2 to 4 decoder as well, the idea is simple, use AND gates. A simple 2 to 4 decoder had AND gates, but if you want to add an enable, extra enable to it, will add a further AND gates to the output to control the output with the required truth table. So what will we do? This was a normal 2 to 4 decoder from this diagram. This is without the enable thing. And let's say add the enable thing, will add an additional layer of AND gates. And each AND gate correspond to the corresponding bit, and centralized with this enable pin. If it's 1, the output will correspond to A1 and A0. Even if it's 0, no output is going to be add, and no particular D is going to be on. All are going to show a 0 output. So extra AND gates as enable functions, regular decoder. So it's very easy to understand. So if one considers enable an input, in that case the circuit can be viewed as a distributing value of signals enable in to 1 to 4 outputs called a demultiplexer. So this concept is also called a demultiplexer. We are going to study in some time. And this is like, if you take enable as an input, we can route whichever output we desire to do so. Let's say if it's a 0, 0 here, this input, let's say this input is x, x can have a value of 0 or 1, this is going to be represented here. So if it is 0, 0, the input is going to be at the D0. Cat have a value of 0 or 1, we are saying it as an x. Let's say if it has 1, 0, you can say that this is going to be represented by this thing. So design a simple valve controller. This is a type of combinational problem. The system has 8 different zones. Only one valve is on at a time to maintain the pressure. A microcontroller is used to control the valve. However, the processor has only 4 outputs. Let's program the microcontroller to indicate which of the 8 valves should be opened using a binary representation. So यहाँ पे हम एक सिस्टम जो बनाना चाह रहे हैं उसमें हम एक स्प्रिंकलर सिस्टम बनाना चाह रहे हैं. द पॉइंट दैट कम्स इनटू माइंड इज़ व्हेन माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स आर देयर, व्हाई डू वी नीड दीज लॉजिकल सिस्टम्स. सो वन आंसर इज़ टू सेव आयोस. माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स हैज़ वेरी लिमिटेड नंबर ऑफ आयोस. इफ़ आवर ऑपरेशन रिक्वायर अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ इनपुट्स और आउटपुट टू बी हैंडल, इन दिस केस आउटपुट्स, we can use such type of decoders to basically make efficient use of the microprocessor. So we can use a 3-to-8 decoder with enable input control by a microprocessor. So this is a microcontroller or microprocessor, and we want to control 8 outputs. However, the microcontroller has only 4 outputs. The problem was this was the bottleneck. Microcontroller had only 4 output pins, but our system require that we control 8 of the valves with individual values. So instead of buying a high price microcontroller, we can use a 3-to-8 decoder and with an enable function, and then we can control any of the 8 output of the sprinkler. And you can see the scalability of this thing. Let's say 3-to-8 decoder, let's say if I have to control a 16 valve, I only need a 4 to 16 decoder. And let's say if I scale it up and I have a 5 to 32 decoder, so I can control basically 32 outputs with just 5 pins. And if you go so on, 6 to 127 or 7 to 6 to 64, 7 to 128, 8 to 256, 9 to 512 decoder, or maybe you can have a 10 to 1024 decoder. That's not possible on an IC, but it's possible when you are using an FPGA or a CPLD to control more number of resources, or scale up or make a decoder by yourself. So this is the advantage of decoder with microcontroller based systems as well. So when enable is 0, all valves are going to be off irrespective of the value of the inputs. So implement m function of n variables with sum of minterm expression 1 to 2 n line decoder, m OR gates for each output. So let's design a system in which we can use the decoder to implement a function. So design and implement a majority function FABC using 3-to-8 decoder. Let's say we have the truth table here, and we want to implement this function with the truth table with the 3-to-8 decoder. So only 3, 5, 6, 7 terms are on. So how will implementation be done with that decoder? So ABCs are going to be used as a selection line, and we can just use a 3-to-8 decoder, and the outputs at which the our outputs are 1, we can use those and tie them up to a OR gate, and hence we have implemented our function. Very easy, very intuitive and very easy. Any function can be represented in such way. So these are some exercises. You can do it by yourself and see what you have learned. The answers are here as well. So implement the function f using 2 to 4 decoders with 2 tri-state buffers. So this is basically tri-state buffer, as discussed earlier, is basically let's say if it's enable, x is going to be at the output. Enable is 1, let's say x is going to be output. If 0 is at the input, 0 is going to be output. If 1 is at the input, 1 is going to be at the output. But if in enable is 0, this wire has going to have no effect at the output. So we are asked to implement the function f using 2 to 4 decoders and 2 tri-state buffers. This is the function that we want to implement. So we just open this circuit. F A B C, F A bar B bar C, and 2 to 4 decoder B and C are used as the input for the decoder. B C and B C bar, and 2 to 4 decoder and 2 tri-state buffers. So this equation is implemented with these circuits. So if you apply the corresponding values, let's say I apply a 1 here, a 1 here, a 1 here, because at this thing the system should give me a 1 at the output. So 1 here means that this is going to be enabled, this is going to be active, this is going to be disconnected, and let's say BC1 means this is going to be 1 and this is going to be 1 and output is going to be 1. So you can see this circuit can be implemented, and the other term you can use it by yourself. A bar B bar C, B bar C, definitely this is going to be 1, and A bar. A bar means that if I apply here, let's say 0, this is going to be 1 and this is going to be disconnected. You can try and do the exercise by yourself for the other thing. 2 to 4 decoder with enable input on OR gate. So these are different exercises that you can use to brush up your skills by using the known famous blocks like decoders, encoders, and use them with the AND or gates to implement the SOPs or POS functions. So the other way around that we want to discuss is basically encoding. Decoders were like decoding. If you have 2 to 4 decoder, you add 2 bits at the input and you decoded them to equivalent 4. And let's say if I want to encode, this is the reverse of a decoder. I have, let's say, 4 inputs and it can be encoded to 2 outputs. And I can have 8 inputs, they can be encoded to 3 outputs. So any number less than 2n, 2n means, let's 2 to the power 3, 8. Anything less than 8 can be encoded to equally numbers. So I can have a 5 to 3 encoder as well, or I can have a 6 to 3 encoder as well. But I cannot have a, let's say, 5 to 2 encoder, because this will not follow the equation. So m elements and n bit binary code. This is the reverse of a decoder. 2 to 4 decoder. So typically an encoder converts a code containing exactly 1 bit, that is a 1 to a binary code corresponding to the position in which 1 appears. So D1 to 1, output is going to be 0001. So let's say if I encode it and only 0th bit is on, it should give the corresponding code. If 1 bit is on, it should give me the code of 0001. So example is octal to binary encoder. Octal means 8, and binary means that equally number will be represented at the output. A decimal to BCD encoder is often used for problems of keypad, because keypads have a larger number of IOs. We cannot waste our microcontrollers or digital system, so we use particularly special encoders that convert the numeric keypad into equally codes. So if 0 is pressed, we are not very concerned about the number of pins that are going from the keypad, but we are concerned what the actual code was. So if 0 is pressed, we should have a code of 0000. If 1 is pressed, 0001. And let's say if 9 is pressed, maybe 01001. 9 code is represented at the output. So we can make our system more easier. A decimal to BCD encoder input 10 bit correspond to the decimal digits 0 through 9. So we have basically 10 codes, because for each bit, maybe we have one output. If 0 is pressed here, D0 is 1, rest are basically 0. But we cannot waste 10 IO pins. So we'll use a encoder that will convert the code to equivalent binary BCD number. So let's say a truth table to decimal to BCD encoder. So if we have, let's say D0 is on, all are 0. If D1 is on, one code is there. If D2 is on, code is 10. D3 is on, code is 11. At any instant from time, two pins cannot be pressed. If they are pressed, it doesn't mean anything. So we are not taking it for now. But if any other pin is pressed, corresponding code will be represented at the output, and will make our calculation based on that output. So you can see A3, we have four equations here: A3, A2, A1, A0. Like we can say then F of 3, F of 2, F of 1, F of 0. These are the possible all 10 bits at the input coming from the keypad. So for A3, you can see only 2 bits are 1. So A3 equation is basically corresponding to D9, D8 and D9, D8 plus D9. Same is the case, A2 is corresponding to D4, D5, D6, D7. A1 is corresponding, you can see these ones where they are 1, those are the numbers in the equation, and D0 is on every alternative bit. So D1, D3, D5, D7, so these are the four equations. If you implement these four equations with OR gates, you can make a simple decimal to BCD decoder. So what if we have a priority, some type of that we want to manage? If more than one input value is pressed, then encoder just design does not work. So we need to ensure that there is some type of priority encoder that accept all possible combination of input value and produces a meaningful result, is basically a priority encoder. So among the ones that appears, it select the most significant input bit position or the least significant input bit position containing a 1, and responds with the corresponding binary code for that position. So priority encoder is going to give us a priority, and other is not going to be selected. So priority encoder encode with 5 inputs, d4, d3, d21, d10. Highest priority is given to the most significant one present. Code outputs a2, a1, a0, and we indicate that at least one is present. So let's say for all r0, nothing is present. Doesn't matter what is at the output. Let's say if d0 is 1, v1 is 1, the output code is 0000. If it's d1 is 1, the output code is corresponding 001. 3. If 3 comes, d0 and d1 both are 1, then priority is given to 1. It will not be given to 0. Same is the case, and we'll take it as a don't care. Same is the case with d2. If d2 1, will not consider d1 and d0, and the code will be for 2. So this is our table for priority encoder. We can solve this table for function a2, a1, a0 and v to get the circuit for the truth table. So a2 is basically d4, a2 only d4 is on. For a1 we have the equation d4 and d3 plus d4 bar, d3 bar and d2. Just by looking at this thing you can understand what that function is. Further you can apply take d4 common and make a common factor. So you can take the equation from a0 and a1 as well and get the output for this thing. So design a 4 input priority encoder with active low inputs. Active low inputs mean the reverse. Active high input means that if input is 1, the output is going to be effective. But active low means that the input is 0, then output is going to be effective. So rather than having zeros, we are going to have ones for outputs that does not matter. So let's say make our truth table in the reverse order, but the outputs are going to remain the same. Only inputs are now complemented. You can say these inputs are now complemented, and you can solve this circuit in the similar way and then get the equations for the encoder. You can solve these equations and get the idea about the encoder, that is opposition encoder. So these were the two concepts that we have covered so far. Decoder, and decoder with enable is also called a DMUX that we have discussed earlier, and then we discussed the encoder, that is opposite of a encoder. Decoder and encoder are basically opposites, and then we are going to also see what is a MUX, multiplexer. Selecting of data or information is critical function in systems and computers. Circuit that performs these things are basically called MUX. A set of information bit with the selection is made, a set of K control selection line for making the selection, a single output. So what is a MUX? A MUX is basically something like this thing, that you have inputs, you have selection lines to route which input is going to be at the output. For MUX there is only one output, and for a DMUX there is only one input. MUX and DMUX are basically opposites. So MUX, you decide by using these lines that which input, let's say 0000, this I0 is going to be at the output. I0, let's say, have a value of x. X value can be a 0, it can be a 1. So whatever is at the I0, x is going to be at the output. If I say 0001, I1 is going to be at the output. So n is less than 2k inputs. So if you have, let's say, 8 inputs, let me say 8 inputs means 7, I'm going to have 3 selection lines, 2 to the power 3 cross 1, you can say, let's say 8 cross 1 mux will have 3 selection lines, 4 cross 1 mux, 2 to the power 2 cross 1 mux, let's say 4 cross 1 mux is going to have 2 selection lines. If I say 2 cross 1 mux, so this is going to have a single selection line. 2 inputs, 1 output. Mux is always going to have 1 output. The example can be something like this thing, that depending upon which liver, there are multiple input paths and only one is going to get at the output. And this is on the control liver that it selects. If it selects 0, 0, maybe this is going to be, this is 1, 1 is going to be at the output. If it's 0, 0, I0 is going to be at the output. 0, 1, this, 1, 0, this line is going to be at. So there are multiple paths. They can have a value. Like in this case, the train is the value. If the value is maybe I2, it doesn't have value, but if its path is connected on this thing, whatever is at the I1 is going to be at the output. So in computer, to select among signals, to implement commands, we use multiplexes. Very important for digital data control. So a simple example that if A is equal to 0, then Z is equal to XY, else Z is equal to X bar Y. A simple conditioning system if you want to apply such type of thing with the digital logic hardware, instead of using high cost PCs, you can use this architecture. So if it's a 0 here, then output is going to be X dot Y. If it's 1 here, the output is going to be X, that is equal to X plus Y. Very simple and intuitive and low cost solution for your digital problems. So trip controller in a car to display mileage, time, speed, etc. We can use a mux. Let's say usually a car has a display and there is a button that can select what display is going to be at your display, because the digits are fixed but the space is less, so we can control whatever want to be at the output. Let's say we have clock, odometer, speed, mileage, but the display is single. So by using the mux, we can decide which output is going to be at the display. Sometimes it's the push button. By push button, we select one display at a time, and then it shows the next thing, and then goes back to the initial thing. So such type of data control requires some type of data control structure, and mux is such a structure that controls the flow of data, and you can decide which thing will be at the output. Don't confuse mux with a decoder. Mux will always have a single output, and demux, as opposite to a mux, will always have a single input. So 4 cross 1 mux requires, let's say, 4 cross 1 mux. 4 cross 1 mux. We can write it as 2 to the power 2 cross 1 mux. So 2 are basically the selection line, 4 are the inputs, 1 is the output. So this is the standard symbol used for a mux. 0, 0, and this is a standard symbol. If I give it 0, 0, I0 is going to be at the output. 0, 1, I1, I2, I3, depending upon what you put at the selection line. And definitely we can put an enable signal to it and hence control the total flow of our system. So if enable is, let's say, 1, our selections are going to be active. And if an enable is 0, it does not matter what is at the input. The output is going to remain 0. So the enable again plays an important role here as well. So to 4 cross 1 mux realization, how 4 plus 1 mux is implemented. You can see the truth table and you can see the equation S1 bar, S0 1 bar, S0 bar plus, and so this is the same thing, S1 bar, S0 bar into I0. One of these statement is going to be executed from this plus sign, this or this or this or this, depending on what you put at the selection. So structure of the mux is going to represent this truth table, and we can make the equivalent structure of the mux. The mathematical equation basically correspond the same thing, mi into ii. And this can go from 0 to the maximum value. So it's M0 and I0, M1 or I1. So this is the total summation equation. Circuit is implemented with 4 AND gates and 2 to 4 line decoder to generate the minterms. So we'll use a 2 to 4 decoder to generate these minterms. These are just 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, as we have seen in the decoder. And we'll use I0s and AND gates. So these are our circuits. If enable is to be put, we'll just add a E at the equation. So this is our MUX circuit. This is basically a 2 to 4 decoder that we have discussed earlier. If I apply 0, 0 here, this is going to be 1. And whatever is the other are for sure 0. So I0, whatever is I0, it's going to be here, and this is going to be represented here. So if it's, let's say, 1, 1, M3 is going to be 1, and others are going to be 0. And whatever is at I3 is going to be here at the OR gate and can be represented at the Y. So this is basically a 4 to 1 multiplexer. We can have a 8 to 1 multiplexer that would again require a decoder, a similar decoder that can generate 8, 0 to 7 outputs, and then this structure is going to be the same. We can have the gate input cost justify how our design is being implemented. One other concept is basically we can have a quad multiplexer. Quad refers to the fact that each input consists of 4-bit wide signal. So the idea is same, but instead of single lanes, now we have 4 lanes of data coming in and data going out. But the selection is going to remain the same. Iski example jo hai wo humne is tarah hi di thi ke agar let's say ek road hai aur road single way road hai. और आपका लेट से एक इशारा उस रोड के ऊपर लगा हुआ है, ठीक है, तो अगर वो सिंगल लेन रोड है तब भी इशारा उसके ऊपर लेट से एक ही लगा हुआ होगा. अगर वो 4 या 6 लेन रोड हो जाएगी तब भी इशारा उतना ही रहेगा, सिग्नल्स उतने ही रहेंगे, सिग्नल्स नहीं बढ़ेंगे. तो सेम इज़ द केस कि अगर मेरी जो मेरे पास इनपुट्स हैं, इफ़ द इनपुट्स आर ऑफ 4-bit द आउटपुट इज़ ऑल्सो गुड बी गोइंग टू 4-bit. But the signals are going to remain the same. So irrespective that we have a quad multiplexer here or maybe octa multiplexer in which each line maybe is of 8 bits, our signal are going to represent, let's say in this case, there are 4 cross 1 mux. So the selection is going to be 2 ki power 2 cross 1, 4 cross 1. So 2 selection lines are going to be there. So build a 8 cross 1 mux using 2, 4, 1 and 1, 2 to 1 mux. So we have these 2, 4 cross 1 mux and 1, 2 cross 1 mux. And this is basically a 8 to 1 mux. 8 to 1 mux in general had, let's say, 0 to 7 inputs. And there were 1 output, and we have 3 selection lines here. So these selection lines are S0, S1, S2. So this is basically a 8 to 1 mux. So exercise, you can see the exercise and solve it accordingly. So a mux can be easily used to implement a function defined by a truth table, a lookup table. This is also called a looked up table. Indeed, the output of the f is mux is equal to the values that are being given. So we can use a mux to implement any function that we require to do so. And how can we do that? Let's say we have a mux and we have a function that we want. Let this is a function that we want to execute. AB00, A01, 1, 101, 111. We can just write these values to the mux, and hence our function is implemented. A and B are going to be used as selection line. And this example was simple example. Let's have a complicated example. A gray to binary code converter. Gray to binary code converter. So gray code, design a circuit to convert a 3-bit gray code to binary code. The most important aspect is to understand how we can formulate the truth table, and then how easy it is to transform the truth table without going to the details of the K-maps or the Boolean expressions directly to a simple sweet circuit. So this was gray code, and this is equally binary code that we saw earlier how to develop this. And we can just use this truth table as a lookup table to convert our system to a mux based digital system. So you can see the patterns here as well, that C is basically following the X. So we can apply the rudimentary logic here, and we can see that C is equal to X. No need to go to extra length to solve this thing. So Y and Z are more complex. So rearranging the table that the input combinations are in counting order. So we are just rearranging the gray code in a form that the outputs are basically in counting order. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just rearranging them in the following order. You can see binary and gray code both are written here. So let's execute this circuit. The truth table is same. Only thing that is converted is that the gray code is now in counting order, and the outputs, mapping outputs, are basically mapped to it. So one thing was clear, that C was equal to X, so no need to solve for X. We'll only solve for Y and for Z. So for every value for ABC, ABC are at going to be the selection. And very simply, we will just do what? X will add the input of the mux here. So 0 was here, 0 is here, 0, 1. We just tied these thing to ground and VCC, and then this circuit is implemented. And same Z is here in the same way, and X was equal to C. No need to draw that thing. So this is your simple sweet gray to binary code circuit. No need to go for K-maps, Boolean algebra, anything. Just simply mux IC, and you can represent your circuit. So note that the multiplexer with fixed input is identical to a ROM with 3-bit address and 2-bit data. This is equivalent to a ROM that we will discuss later as well. So we can apply the rudimentary logic here. And rudimentary logic, we can simplify this thing and execute this circuit with more simplification. One can further simplify the circuit Let's say if you want to simplify it, we can just apply the rudimentary logic here, and this was like 4×1 mux was used to develop this circuit. Let's say we want to do it with a simpler thing. So B is following the function f for value of a equal to 0, and if value of a is equal to 1, B is basically a not of B, rudimentary logic here. And you can use a 2×1 mux rather than a 4×1 mux. So implement any m function n plus 1 variable using a 2n to 1 line mux. Find the truth table for the function based on the values for the first n variable. Separate the truth table rows into pairs, and for each pair the output defines the rudimentary function of the final variable. So let's apply rudimentary logic to our circuits. First we solved with the 8×1 mux. Now we'll solve it with the 4×1 mux. So you can see for C, this is following, x is following C. Here it is not of C. Not of C. Here for every value the output is basically C bar and these are the values. So here it's C bar and here it's C. So x is all equal to C, but you can see 0 1 0 1 0 1, so it's C. 0 1, it's 1 0 not of C, and 1 0 not of C. So whatever values you have here, 0 1 C not of C. So you can execute this thing with a 4×1 mux and get the circuit accordingly. You can implement these functions. Let's say this is a standard problem that can be solved with the 8×1 mux, but the technique we have studied, you can use these techniques and use a 4×1 mux to execute the circuit. So yeah, here you can see for every value the output equal to 1 irrespective of anything. Here if you map the last value 0 1, the output is not of this thing. It's the same. For every value input, output is 0. So we'll apply a 4×1 mux and apply these 1 C bar C0 at the input, get the output. So last problem is basically controller for a rear light of a car. So word description of the problem: design a circuit that controls the rear light of a car, left and right lights. Assume a single lamp in each of the rear light. So assume a single lamp. This car is a very complicated car, but we'll assume there is only one lamp at the output. So the input of the controller are LT, RT, emergency brake, and a internal signal of 1 Hz frequency. Because the light is going to blink, so it needs a 1 Hz frequency on, off at a period of 1 second. So we are going to have a let's say left, right, left turn signal, right turn signal, emergency brake, and we are going to have some priorities, output signals, left power control of the rear light, power control of the right rear light. So some rules that we need to have in our truth table: the brake overrides the emergency signal. So if brake overrides the emergency EM signal, the left turn and right turn overrides the brake signal, and implement two power control signal as minimize SOP, decoder with NOR gates and multiplexer. These three technologies we need to use. First we make the truth table. So left brake emergency blink. You can see the blink is basically on off, on off, on off. It basically shows that whenever you place an indicator, it becomes on and off, on and off. Whatever is value at those on and off will depend upon our initial problem description. So if all are basically zero, output is going to be zero. Just blink doesn't make anything because this is just a frequency signal. So if emergency light is on, then it is going to be make the light on. If brake light is on, it is going to be on. So if brake light is on, it's going to be on. Brake light is on, it overrides, it's going to be on. And if brake and emergency lights are on simultaneously, brake is going to have the override. So LT not on, LT life in left indicator. So you see when you make a left indicator, it goes on off, on off, on off with a clock. So this signal is basically the clock signal. So if this signal is off, one indicator is not going to blink. But if left indicator is blink and the pulse is on, it is going to be on. So if left and emergency are simultaneously, the priority is to the left, but the blink is off. Blink is on, brake is on, so override is given. So basically left is on and blink is on, so it is going to be zero, because again left has a priority with the brake frequency signal. And if all are on, then basically one. Same is the case with the right. You can make the same table. So we can solve with the K maps. Find the optimum biggest pair in the power of 2. Let's say 4, 4, 4. And then we can solve this thing and have the minimized SOP. And for the right and the left, I hope you can solve these things now. We can implement these functions with complements and NOR gates. We have just seen this thing a little earlier with encoder. And lastly, we can use a 8x1 multiplexer to optimize our results. So let's say blink, we map this thing with the blink. So for every value of blink, output is going to be zero. For every value of blink, the output is going to follow. For every value of blink, the output is going to remain 1. So we can apply this thing with a multiplexer. Instead of using a 16x1 multiplexer, we'll use a 8x1 multiplexer. And then apply this thing. 0, BL, 1. These were the three members of the optimization factors. So we applied these things and hence have a optimized circuit. Same goes for the right signal. So this was it for combinational logic. और इसके अंदर हमने सारा जो है चीज़ें देखी, जिसके अंदर हमने वी रिव्यूड इनकोडर्स, डिकोडर्स, मार्क्स, डी मार्क्स, प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग मेथड थ्रू विच वी कैन बेसिकली सॉल्व एनी प्रोसीजरल प्रॉब्लम. So I hope you understand this thing, and if you have any queries or confusions, you can write to me or in the comment box so that we can have a review. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.